Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather around. Today, we're going to be looking at Imperial fractions. And I know some of you are saying, Mr. Wellwood, I can't stand fractions. Well, lucky you. 5 out of 4 people have problems with fractions, but no more. I will show you how to do fractions, so fractions don't do you. Here we go. Until the United States gets with the program of the entire rest of the globe, we're still stuck with imperial fractions. That's inches. I happen to have a ruler right here. Some of you can't tell the difference between inches and millimeters. Yes?
You just pointed to the wrong sides.
Nicely done. I think you're going to ace this section. Unless you're completely illiterate, they are labeled. This has millimeters right there to tell you that this is millimeters. Surprisingly, this is not 1 millimeter, but there we are. If you can't tell the difference between millimeters, centimeters, and inches, I want to meet your elementary school teacher. Down here, this is where we're looking at. We're going to look at inches, but this has got a whole bunch of lines, especially there. I like this a bit better. This is making my head explode. What do I do now? This. We're going to look at 0 to 1 inch. So here is 0 to 1 inch. A quick way of writing inch is 2 little quotes like that. That's inch. This is feet. That's a lot different.
The little children of Stone Age, beneath the haunted moon, for fear that daybreak might come too soon.
That's inches. Now, we want to deal with fractions. I hate fractions. Let's write at the top here just so we remember what we're doing, because I know some of you guys have a hard time with that. We're going to look at fractions. So if I go and I take a blueberry pie, and usually when my wife bakes a blueberry pie, I just say, just cut it in half, because I can only eat 2 pieces. And then I would eat 1 of the 2 pieces. And then I would eat the second piece. So if I ate 1 of the 2 pieces, I could write that as 1 of 2. Yep.
Isn't that 1/2?
Yes, yes it is. But it's actually 1/2 because it's 1 of 2 pieces. If you had a quiz by your teacher and you scored 1 out of 2, what kind of percentage did you get?
50%.
Nice. Or you could also look at it, if I have $0.50, how many cents do I have?
You have no cents, Mr. Wellwood.
Uh-huh. So 0.5. I'm just putting 50 just because I love zeros. Zero is my favorite number. If I score 1 out of 2, I got 1/2 of it right. I got 0.5 of them right. I got 50% of them right. I'm not doing too well. Although technically that's a pass. So knowing that with blueberry pies, what if I got kids, right? So there's got to be a piece for me, a piece for my wife, and a piece for each of my 2 kids. If I go with this, and I take a blueberry pie, and I give you 1 piece, how much of the pie did you get? Yep.
1/4.
Nice. So you'd have 1 of the 4 pieces. Now, if you had a quarter in $0.25, how much money would that be? Anyone? Anyone? Bueller? If I gave you a quarter, how many pennies is that worth?
Well, that would be...
You moved.
I know, I'm sneaky like that.
Okay, how many?
That would be 25 cents.
So I could write that as 0.25. If I scored 1 out of 4 on a quiz, I got 25%. This is not a pass. Okay, that's kind of where it's coming from. Maybe you don't know this. Maybe you don't know that 1/4 is 0.25. Here's what you do. You take your calculator, you punch in 1 divided by 4. Your answer is going to be 0.25. Just in case you don't know this off the top of your head, punch it in your calculator, 1 divided by 4. Let's go back to imperial measurement. If I take 0 to 1 inch and I split it right here, I would have 1 part, 2 parts. When I get to this piece, I got 1/2 of an inch. This is 1/2 of an inch. Maybe I want to go smaller. I could go here and I would have 1/4. This would be 2 of 4 pieces and this would be 3/4 of an inch. I can go smaller. I can split it into 8 pieces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This would be 1/8. This would be 2/8. I'm writing it on the bottom because if you leave your math equation like this, your math teacher is going to come and punch you in the denominator. You got to reduce the number. If you can divide them both by 2, you can reduce it. 2 divided by 2 is 1. 8 divided by 2 is 4. Essentially, if I have a blueberry pie and I gave you 2 of 8 pieces, you ate a quarter of my pie, you pig. 2 eighths, this would be 3 eighths, this would be 4 eighths, again, it's only half. This would be 5 eighths, this would be 6 eighths, this would be 7 eighths, this would be 8 eighths, you ate the whole pie, you pig, why would you do that? I can go smaller, I can go down this way and split it into 16 pieces. Oh my gosh.
Where are you going with this, Mr. Wellwood?
Completely there. So this would be 1/16, this would be 2/16, but you can reduce it. 3/16, 4/16, which is still the same fraction, 5/16, 6/16, 7/16, 8/16, which is still a half. You can't see that. Let me help you out what I'm talking about. Where was I? 7? 8/16. This would be 9/16, 10/16, 11/16, 12/16. Cool story. One of my mechanic buddies like, Wellwood, can I borrow your 3/4-inch wrench? I said, I don't have a 3/4-inch, but I got a 6/8 wrench. Nah, I really need a 3/4. Okay. 13/16, 14/16, you can reduce that. 15/16, and then 16/16, you pick. This is basically your fractions. Now you can get a tape measure that has all the fractions written on it, which for some of you is like, oh my gosh, I gotta get me one of those. So if I need to measure off of this, there's no indicators to tell me what I've got. So I need to find a different way of doing this. This one tells me each one of these lines is 1/32nd of an inch. That's pretty cool. I don't usually go to 1/32nd of an inch when I'm working with anything and gonna use a ruler. There are better ways to be more precise. But for woodworking, that's pretty good measurement for 1/32nd of an inch. I might use that in setting the float on a carburetor if I had to. Over here, I have 64ths of an inch. My head wants to explode just looking at that. Over here is 16ths of an inch. Each one of these lines is 1/16th of an inch. There are 16 lines all the way across. If I wanted to find 5/8, I know that in the middle is 4/8. That means this has to be 1, 2, 3, 4/8. That's gotta be 5/8. If I gotta find 7/16, I know that in the middle is 8/16. I can go back 1, 7/16. If I need to find 3/8, I gotta look at this split into 8. I know that's 4/8. That means 1, 2, that's gotta be 3/8. Fractions are a pain in the butt, but they're here to stay. So this is kind of how you read them.